Racing to the 2021 Preakness Stakes, the middle jewel of the Triple Crown, and some big news announced today on the Preakness Trail. Let's start off with Mandaloon, the second place finisher in the Kentucky Derby, trained by Brad Cox. He is not going to be running in the Preakness Stakes. Also, his stablemate, Caddo River, who was last seen in the Arkansas Derby, did not run in the Kentucky Derby. They were maybe going to point towards the Preakness. Both those horses are out of the Preakness Stakes, and we could be looking now at a 9-horse field for the Preakness. So interesting developments that definitely lowers the odds on all the major contenders. And today we're going to take a look. Yesterday we took a look at the speed and kind of running style. We'll update that. But with the speed figures now in from the Kentucky Derby for Beyer, of course, there's two, three different speed figures out there. Actually, there's about 7 or 8 total speed figure services. And of course, Beyer speed figures have kind of been the longest in the industry. They're a little bit more basic. They don't account for pace. They theoretically don't account for class, although it does seem like they seem to factor that in a little bit. And it doesn't account for ground loss and wind. So they're more of a straight up speed figure based on pars and what the horses have been projected to run and what they ran in the past. Medina Spirit, lifetime top 102 Beyer speed figure in the Kentucky Derby. Midnight Bourbon is at a 96, Concert Tour at a 94. And then you got to go down to Unbridled Honors 91, Risk Taking 89, and Rombauer an 88. So Medina Spirit totally sticks out as a favorite based on the Beyer speed figures. The Brisnet speed figures wanted to bring this into focus because Medina Spirit did not have the fastest speed figure of the big stakes races last week. Malathot got a 103 in winning the Kentucky Oaks, and there's a possibility she could be running in the Belmont Stakes. Meanwhile, impressive winner Mask Parade, he won by about 10 lengths over Ghazali. He ended up with a 102 Brisnet speed figure, and Medina Spirit with that 101. So Medina Spirit not rated as with as much of a gap between him and some of these other contenders on the Brisnet scale. Now the time form, the two horses coming back from the Derby that we know of at this point, Medina Spirit a 122 and then Midnight Bourbon a 110. And again, that's quite a big gap in that difference. Keep me in mind also being considered for the Preakness Stakes. He had a little bit of a trip trouble, but you know, his three races overall this year and last year, he was never really fast, even in that Kentucky Jockey Club juvenile win. Now, also, the speed figure chart, I wanted to pull up the 10 furlong speed figure chart because it's not exactly one length equals 1 point on the Beyer scale at 10 furlongs. Based on the distance, the beaten lengths chart is adjusted based on how far they were beaten. And so in this example, if you're only beaten by a neck at 10 furlongs, your speed figure is basically the same as a winner. If you lose by a half a length at 10 furlongs, you're beaten a speed figure. So if the winner gets a 102 and you lose by like a half a length like Mandaloon did, then you're only going to get a 101. You're only going to get a 1 point dock. But what this does show is that on the Beyer scale, this is the Beyer beaten length speed figure, two turns, and it's at 10 furlongs. That 6-point, 7-point edge for Medina Spirit projects him favored by about 4 to 5 lengths, and that's usually starting to be pretty tough to beat. Now, we're going to handicap the race once we get post positions and some other information, final field and all of that. But, you know, I think on paper, I think Rombauer and Crowded Trade maybe are capable of coming in with some new lifetime tops. So that's where I think you could possibly see them. And then, you know, with the career best, I think you've got Rombauer, Crowded Trade, and Concert Tour, the possibility of running a career best speed figure. So that's how you need to look at some of these speed figures. We're going to come back, still a lot to be determined, pedigree analysis and final handicapping information last week. If you missed it, the pace profile is up for the 2021 Preakness Stakes.